Hello everyone, this is Yu. I will present guaranteed globally injected 3D deformation processing. This paper is co-authored by Fang Yu, Li Mingchen, Jiang Chengfan-Fu, and Danny Kaufman. We present injective deformation processing, or IDP, a new framework for guaranteed globally injected 3D deformation processing. Close and contacting geometries are everywhere, ranging from daily human-object interactions to tolerancing in the design of mechanical structures. Correctly ensuring geometries are both non-intersecting and non-inverting is critical across applications. In 3D printing, for example, input models must be free of intersections with suitable margins so that prints are feasible and correct. Similarly, animation pipelines that ignore contact can produce unsightly artifacts and so unusable frames, like we see here. Modeling with digital tools is generally time-consuming and requires expert skills to create complex shapes. On the other hand, in the real world, starting with just few simple shapes, we can all quickly use contact to manipulate and form complex geometries. We aim to provide the same opportunities in digital tools. Likewise, for high-quality applications of parameterizations, artists generally require maps that are both non-inverting and non-overlapping. For 2D injective deformation processing, we currently have powerful and efficient tools. However, when it comes to 3D globally injective deformation processing, very few options are available and existing methods are severely challenged. On the one hand, many methods apply iterative contact modules from physically based animation to resolve intersections in geometry processing. These methods are efficient and easily support large deformations. However, this efficiency and expressiveness came at the cost of reliability. Intersections are rarely fully resolved due to lack of convergence, while the inversions are generally ignored. Alternatively, and more recently, scaffolding-based methods have been applied. To enforce bijectivity, negative space is discretized with the scaffolding. However, without refinement, this triangulation introduces artificial locking from shared elements, as it distorts with the prime mesh. While in 2D, this locking can be reduced by global remeshing, in 3D, it cannot, and local remeshing suffers from severe artificial locking that prevents deformation from hitting the whole container, as it should. Here, the scaffolding mesh connecting the object and the container on the side quickly adds the severe artificial shearing penalty. This penalty prevents the inner cylinder from sliding. Yet this motion would not cause any intersections and so should be allowed. Let's start by setting our general problem. A wide range of tasks, as I demoed in just a few minutes, all reduced to finding a stat X that locally minimize a mesh distortion away from the rest shape X bar. It is measured by an elastic energy, for example, near hooking or symmetric directory. The trick here is to do so while ensuring that the deforming domain never overlaps nor inverts. To ensure non-overlap, we add the recently developed incremental potential contact of IPC barrier energy to our minimization objective. The barrier exerts a large repulsion between all pairs of surface primitives that diverges as these pairs become closer. In turn, the barrier is smoothly clamped at the user-specified threshold to ensure continuity for both its gradient and Hessian. This being said, the barrier can both be efficiently evaluated and effectively optimized with higher order gradient-based descent with projected Newton. Directly minimizing the energy when starting from a usual initializer is both extremely challenging and often undesirable in many applications. Instead, we time step the gradient system with implicit error using large time steps. Effectively, as we see here, these have a very simple geometric interpretation. At each step, we adjust at a mass-weighted quadratic term, penalizing the distance between the prior and the current iterations positions. The ratio between quadratic terms and the original optimization object is just the artificial step size, h. By solving these subproblems progressively, we can efficiently converge to the solution of the original minimization problem. And moreover, useful for many applications like handle-based deformation. We also obtain pleasing evolutions over these artificial time steps. To get a better feel for its behaviors, we can test IDP's artificial time stepping framework on a benchmark inspired by John's paper. In each setup, we are going to try to expand the geometry to fill its encoding cage while continuously ensuring non-overlap, non-inversion. Here, we see that even when no constrictions are in the cage, for example, in the cylinder example, the scaffolding method can quickly lock and so fail to make almost any progress at all. On the other hand, we can see that even for complex shapes enclosed in complex cages like an hourglass, our deforming material remains unlocked and so manages to both pass through the bottleneck and fill the whole container while ensuring a globally injective deformation. While we've already seen IDP's application for fixed boundary conditions, in many applications such as manipulation, animation, and modeling, we need to handle boundary conditions that change over time. Doing so while continuously ensuring non-overlap have remained a long-standing challenge. In our setup, we designate a subset of vertices B with target positions. We then define a simple quadratic penalty between these vertex dots and their targets. Here, we illustrate our resulting mode of IPC's boundary condition handling and illustrate it with pseudocode. While current vertex positions remain far away from their targets, we iteratively increase penalty stiffness so that the Newton solver can appropriately handle them. However, once they reach their targets within epsilon distance, we remove the penalty and fix the vertices, so solve the optimization in the resulting subspace via projection. Finally, following the original IPC formula, notice that we continuously enforce non-intersection and non-inversion in line search, and so reach the target without violating injectivities along the way. Here, these bars are fixed on the top, and the bottom is applied moving boundary conditions. We show different behaviors with different energies used. What we've so far covered is the construction of our IDP system for globally injective deformation processing. Let me now show you how it works in some important applications. With our system in place, for each one, all that is required is just change of energies involved and the choice of geometries. Here, our first application is norm flow. We first define the normal direction n for each surface node. And beta here is flow speed. While traditional normal flow methods generally must merge or remove singularities, IDP successfully remains watertight and intersection free without merging or splitting the triangulated surface. Here, we demonstrate both outwards and inwards normal flow with 3D shapes as well as another CAD geometry. The last one is the expansion of a 2D Chinese font, Tao, which means the principle of everything in nature. Next, as I discussed earlier, many input and emission require fixing from intersections in order to be usable. We have already seen that the mousy animation had interpenetration artifacts between the arm and the belly. Fortunately, we can fix it with our IDP framework. Let me show you how we can achieve this. First, we store the input animation sequence at F and start cooking up another animation sequence. We start by solving a corrected frame X1 from input F1. And then sequentially correct a sequence X2, X3, one by one. Each animation pose starts from the previous frame's corrected position, but is drawn by the optimization towards the corresponding input frame. Each of these corrections solves an individual optimization where we have ambient energy and discrete shell bending energy and our barrier. In this way, we can obtain a new consistent animation sequence without penetration. Since here, we apply discrete shell deformation energy, we can directly and controllably preserve both intrinsic and extrinsic surface features. IDP both fix the intersection and also gives nice deformation effects at these new contacting points around the corrections. On the other hand, minimizing max distortion is a common technique to resolve severe distortion energy or distortion concentrations. Here, we can first define an exponential factor P with respect to a distortion measure and then apply IDP to optimize the powered energy while preserving the global injectivity. Now we show a 2D example. Note as demoed here, the IDP framework resolves both 3D and 2D problems. Now, as promised, we can also apply IDP to enable modeling and layout of complex geometries, starting directly from primitive shapes. With real resolved contact, we can do this by simply copying real-world manual instructions with simple manipulations. As demonstrations, I will first follow rough directions to make and arrange dumplings. Note that for modeling, we also enable plasticity or reinversible deformation. Please see our paper for details on how we do this and the corresponding remeshing required for the severe deformations this enables. Here, I will start by squashing a sphere, then warping, pinching, and squeezing. Finally, we lay out them on a plate. This is a rendered view of the delicious dumplings. Next, I can similarly fold and arrange artificial flowers. Again, starting with simple primitive shapes. For example, I can start by bending a strip. Copy and paste it. And then winding. Similarly, I can create other flowers. Please see our paper for details. Once done, I can copy and paste the flowers in a bowl geometry and then shrink the bowl to arrange them in a vase. And here is the final rendered view of the flower arrangement created by IDP. Extending recent results in physical simulation, I've shown how we developed IDP, the first framework for robustly deforming in 3D with injectivity guarantees. We've performed extensive benchmark testing to confirm IDP's reliable behavior in practice, and I've shown just a few of the wide range of applications potentially possible. Looking ahead, we are excited to see what geometries users would be able to create with IDP, and likewise, what new applications will it be able to support. To enable such future applications and extensions, we will be releasing our code for IDP. Thanks.